Lorsque l'on réfléchit à l'écologie industrielle,
When we start thinking about industrial and scientific ecology, one of the first concepts that comes to mind is that of food chain or trophic network. This applied to industrial activities consists in linking economic activities so that the waste of some becomes resources for others. So we use the analogy to biosphere and we talk about industrial symbiosis. The Kellenborg port was one of the very first attempts to achieve industrial ecology. It became a global reference, and industrial ecology would not be what it is today if we had discovered this masterful example of the principle. It's based on the sensible control of raw material within a territory to allow the setting up of an industrial ecosystem where each company uses the waste from others. Kellenborg is a small port on the coast of Denmark. It has 20,000 inhabitants and it's one of the rare port structure accessible at this latitude. In Kellenborg, there is steam produced that's sold to Statoil, and Statoil sells its cooling water. The power plant produces steam for Novo Nordisk, one of the largest producers of insulin in the world, to the Gyproc company, which builds plaster construction panels, and to the municipality of Kellenborg that uses the steam for urban heating. As for the water rejected by the power station, it's used by a fish farm, and there is a desulfurization unit that allows producing gypsum, which is sold to Gyproc, which no longer needs to procure gypsum from Spain. And then ashes are reused by a company that produces cement, vanadium and nickel. The Kellenborg industrial area shifted from a linear production to a circular production in which all production units are interconnected. But this Kellenborg symbiosis was not achieved over one day. It all started when Statoil, the refinery, set up in Kellenborg in the 60s. They signed an agreement with the municipality for their water supply because they really had a problem with water resources. Then the company turned to other suppliers as it was developing by signing partnerships with other industrial production sites that were established nearby. Other projects appeared and cooperation developed. Use of steam, of gas, of water, etc. And today, 26 companies are cooperating with the municipality, and that includes farms, fisheries, which are supplied in fertilizers, heat and water. This Kellenborg symbiosis is an initiative that was born from the willingness of companies, but with the constant support of local authorities. And it's a local initiative based on transparency and communication between all stakeholders that set up business close to one another. Each and every member can share materials, water, energy, and make profit. The ecosystemic approach in this system and in these synergies was only noticed lately at the end of the 80s, beginning of the 90s, after 20 years of operation. Jill Christensen, a former director of Novo Nordisk, considers that symbiosis in Kellenborg is a non-project achieved by a non-organization. Other entities and businesses also developed in parallel to this group. So apart from the economic cycle, partners see joint development opportunities. So they develop synergies to replace raw materials, but they also pool up to produce certain products like compressed air or to reuse certain waste together. They are now planning to use renewable energies for the entire industrial park. If the substitution potential is important, as shown in this graph, which is difficult to read because of the large number of exchanges which are potentially feasible between different types of industries, there are still many obstacles for the development of these industrial symbioses. These are without redundant. So the industrial park has no redundant, as opposed to a scientific ecosystem. Because in an ecosystem, functional groups are made up of a large number of species which do not use exactly the same resources and which are used as resources for other species which belong to other functional groups. In an industrial ecosystem, each functional group is made up of a very small number of companies. So there is a lack of flexibility in the exchanges or in the flows due to the limited number of companies and due to the type of infrastructures which are required to circulate the products from one industry to the other. Second obstacle, disturbance in the system if one of the partner fails. Because if one of the partner goes on strike or closes down, it's the whole system which can be disturbed. And then we see that symbiosis is easier when partners are close to one another. Last problem, the business relationship between the partners. It's difficult to share resources and materials when they do not represent a certain value for all parties involved. So the setting up of industrial ecology is not obvious. Maybe it's possibly a utopia, because this type of system does not really exist in nature. Otherwise, we wouldn't have had coal or oil, which is biomass that accumulated over millions of years. In the case of Kalundborg, there were many geographical and historical opportunities that encouraged the formation of this symbiosis. However, the setting up of such industrial parks is booming, especially in Asia and in China. So beyond the geography, we also need economic, political, regulatory incentives to emerge networks which can operate. But in any case, an analogy with biomimetism and ecosystems is a way to challenge the obstacles we have in our industrial societies and really start moving things. Maybe now we need to move towards a more dynamic dimension of the ecology to combine ecological and economic performance.